Today's subject is English of standard 3rd and the name of the lesson is Pretty as a Picture. Pretty means beautiful as a picture. Dear students, this is a story of 3rd standard. We will go through this story and we will try to understand the meaning of this phrase, pretty as a picture. Students, observe this picture. You can see this is a class picture of standard 3rd. Students are standing here and there on the bench and all that. See the benches. See the condition of the class. Are you happy to see this? See this. The school left and children left the school. See the condition of the school and the classroom. How do you feel? Okay. We will find out the answer for this. Okay. Just now, students, we observed a classroom with the children and after the school hours also. That was so messy, isn't it? And you felt very bad to see that. I too. Correct? Now, here one question is there. Why should we keep our classroom clean? We will find out the answer for this question by going through this lesson. You can see here standard 3rd classroom. Okay. And we will hear a story of standard 3rd from these students. We'll start now. Right on the first day of school, our new class teacher, Miss Nina, told us that the last period on every Friday would be a story time. We all decided immediately she must be the best teacher in the world. So, Friday came and we got more and more excited till at last the bell rang for the last period. We reminded her right away about her promise. Yes, of course, she said happily. But as she looked around the class, she could see her face changing. Oh dear, I was going to tell you such a lovely story. But it looks as if that will have to wait. No, said everyone. That's not fair. She said, look at the classroom. How can we enjoy a story with all this rubbish all over the floor? So everyone went scurrying around picking up paper and pencil stuffs and putting them in the waste paper basket. What a confusion there was. But Miss Nina was not satisfied. The desks and benches are all crooked, she said. So up popped everyone, once again straightened out the rows quickly and put them all in perfect order. That's much better, she said. But look at yourselves. Ribbons undone, shirts hanging out, shoelaces open, belts askew. Anything for the story, we thought. And as quickly as possible, we tidied ourselves up. We kept asking the kids around us to tell us if we were looking tidy enough. One last thing, Miss Nina said. You will be in a hurry when the story is over. So, how about putting away all your things into your bags right now? All the books, all notebooks. Okay? Don't forget the compass box. Have you put away your pencil, your rubber, your ruler, the pack of color pencils? Good. Now, your tiffin and water bottle. There is a place for everything. So, put everything in its right place. But at last it was all done and Miss Nina finally smiled broadly. Now, that's my favorite class, she said. And she told us a really funny story about a king and his clown. Only it ended too soon because time was not there. Now, on Monday, when the week began, our class monitor said he had a good idea and he wanted us to listen. He said that we must practice straightening up the classroom and ourselves quickly, just within 5 minutes. That way, we would have time for long stories on Fridays. So, they wanted to drive up a 5 minutes drill. Now students, we will go through the 5 minutes drill of standard third. Okay? The first minute, start from the last kid in every line, collect and pass on all paper and rubbish to the kid in front. They go and put it in the waste paper basket. Means here passing the parcel game. Like that, the last line students, they go on passing the rubbish and the papers to the front child and the front child will put that all thing in the basket or the dustbin. Okay? What about the second minute? In the second minute, he said, come out of your place and straighten your desk. Look at the lines on the floor to help you keep it just right. Kids on the ends tell you, if your desk is out of the line, means keeping the desk and benches in a line, this is the task for second minute. Third minute, tie shoelaces and ribbons, tuck in blouses and shirts, straighten dresses and belts, face your partners to make sure that everything is all right. Means in the third minute we have to make us clean and tidy. Correct? Personal things you have to make proper. On the fourth minute, pack your bags, check all books, notebooks, compass boxes, color pencils, tiffins, water bottles. Have I written my homework? Have I forgotten anything? Yes, these are all for the fourth minute. Means packing the bag properly and we have to put all the things inside the bag at their places. Okay, this is the task for the fourth minute. And on the fifth minute, sit down quietly and try to guess the story Miss Nina's going to tell. Okay? This is about the 5 minutes drill they practiced. Miss Nina was so pleased with the 5 minute drill. She said she would also help. She said she would keep looking at her watch and tell us after every minute to hurry up. We practiced starting on Monday itself. And do you know what Miss Nina said at the end of the 5-minute drill? She said, "Our class looked as pretty as a picture." We got a full 25-minute story this Friday. This is all about the story of Standard Third. How was the story? Wasn't it nice? Students, you also practice the 5 minutes drill in your class. Okay? Now, here tidy up the classroom. See the classroom? Whenever you work or you do any craft work or any project work, after that, please try to tidy up the classroom. See students, here the children, they are cleaning the board, isn't it? Yes. If you do this all work in a team, then it will take very less time to complete. See, here the students, they are cleaning their school. Here we can see that girl is putting the rubbish in the dustbin. We have to use the dustbin kept in the classes and also in the school campus so that we can keep our classroom and school campus clean and tidy. Keep the class clean and tidy. You can draw these symbols on the school wall or in the classroom also. Yes, we will see what all we have to put in the bag before leaving the school. See here, the tiffin box, water bottle, compass box, notebooks, textbooks, pencil, scissors, erasers, color box, all that we have to collect and we have to put inside the bag before leaving the school. We have to take the responsibility of our materials, isn't it? See this, everyone will keep our classroom clean. Here we can see some rules in this classroom. See, these are classroom rules of that class. You also can make your classroom rules. Okay? Anything you can write of your own classroom. See how the classrooms they look when they are neat, clean and tidy. The teacher will also become happy to teach and students also they become happy to listen and to grasp the studies or learning. Here we can see the picture of cleanliness in the school, means outside the school. Yes, here they are separating the recycled materials like bottles, cans, plastic bottles we can see, and papers in different basket, isn't it? This also makes us happy when we do this in teamwork. Keep your school tidy. Students, to clean your classrooms before the start of break and at the end of the last lesson. This is the time to clean your class. At the end of breaks and at the end of the day, leave with the chairs and tables orderly arranged. Otherwise, what some students they do? They run from the class. The benches, they fall and all the arrangement, it becomes crooked. So not to do like that, we have to leave the chairs and tables orderly arranged. Last one, look after your classrooms. Think of it as your home. How we think of our home? We want our home neat and tidy. And we also try to keep our home neat, clean and tidy. Like that only, our classroom, we must take care of it. We have to keep it clean and tidy. Now, dear students, we will move to exercise part. Mention the things that make a class untidy. We saw so many pictures of untidy class and also of the neat class. Now, remember the untidy class and tell me the things that make that class untidy. Paper and pencil stubs on the floor. Yes, correct. See this picture, I will show you again. Books all over the place. Crooked desks and benches. Means desk and benches are not in order. Crooked and dusty charts on the wall. Yes, we hang different educational charts on the wall, isn't it? So they should be proper. If they are crooked, they add to the untidy class. Mention the things that make a person untidy. Just now we gone through about the class untidy. Now here about a person untidy means we have to collect the things. Okay, we will start. Uncombed hair. Yes, see this boy. He is looking untidy because of his hairs and his dresses. Ribbons and belts undone. See this girl. Shirts and blouses hanging out. Shoelaces untied. Buttons missing. Unironed uniforms, etc. These are all the different things that make a person untidy. Isn't it? Where you will put the following. Dear students, here some things are given. We have to say where we put all these things. Okay. First one, pencil. Where we keep our pencil? Correct. In compass box. Or we call that one as geometry box. Second thing is cup. Where we keep the cup? On the cup stand, isn't it? Next one, banana peel, the cover of the banana that we will put in the dustbin. Doll. Yes, after playing with the doll, we have to keep our doll in the doll house or the place where we keep all our toys, isn't it? Use the following phrases in sentences of your own. This is from your textbook. First, we will understand the meaning of phrases. What is a phrase? Phrase means it is a small group of words that adds meaning to a word. Got this? Yeah, it does not give a complete sense of that meaning, that sentence, but it has 2 to 3 words, a group of words. We will go through some of the examples, means from the text only. Okay, first one is spike and span. The meaning of spike and span means clean and tidy. We have to use this phrase, okay, in our own sentence. You can make your own sentence. I will give you one example and I will show you how to make a sentence using the phrase given. Okay. See this. The whole house was spick and span before Diwali. Before Diwali, we clean our house. Isn't it? That only here it is written. The whole house was spick and span before Diwali. What this? This word should be there in the sentence. Second, as clean as whistle. Here whistle means extremely clean and tidy. Okay, the meaning of the whistle is extremely clean. Okay, now we will make a sentence here. I saw that my room was as clean as a whistle before my grandparents arrived. See this? Here we used as clean as a whistle. Means my room became extremely clean before my grandparents' arrival. Got this? Third one, pretty as a picture. See, this is the title of our lesson. Correct? After they had hung the new curtains, the room looked as pretty as a picture. See, here we use as pretty as a picture. Means that room became a beautiful one like a picture. Okay, got this? Yes, dear students, you try to make your own sentence using these phrases. Now we will move to the grammar part. Today we will study about the simile. First we will understand the meaning of the simile and then we will go through some of the example to understand the concept. Okay? What is the meaning of the simile? Simile means comparing two things, okay, to one another using the words like or as. Means we are going to compare the two things. And while comparing, we use like this word or we use as. See this. Either this or this. We have to use any one word and we have to make the sentence. For example, she is as sweet as a pie. See, here we use as. Okay, comparison is there between that girl sweetness and the pie sweetness. So, here we use as word to compare these two things. Next one, he can run like the wind. Now comparison between that boy and the wind, correct? And we used like. See here, we use the word like. Again we will read, he can run like the wind. For the students, this is called simile. Means we have to use either like or as while making the sentence. See, this pizza is as cold as ice. See again, the comparison between pizza and ice. And what we use? as cold as, this word is used. And we compare these two things. Okay, next one. My grandpa walks as slow as a turtle. You can see a grandpa and you can see a turtle. You know that turtle is a slow walker, correct? Here our grandpa, yeah, he is compared with the turtle because he walks very slowly. And the word used is here as. My grandpa walks as slow as turtle. In simile, two things are compulsory. Number one, comparison should be there between the two things. Okay. Second point is, we have to use the word like or as while making the sentence. Third one, as playful as a kitten. Okay. Next one, as sweet as pie. You can use anywhere this sentence. That girl is as sweet as a pie. Correct? Colorful like crayons. Here, like word is used. Colorful like crayons. Okay? Next one. As tall as a giraffe. See, height we are comparing. And the word used here, as tall as giraffe. Got this, students? I hope you understand. Students, try to compare the things by using the words like or as, and try to frame the sentences for simile. Okay?